Cloudflare is piecing together the agent puzzle using MCP, durable objects, and now WorkOS AuthKit. So in this video, we'll deploy a remote MCP server authenticated with AuthKit, and we'll do it with a convenient deploy to Cloudflare button. Let's get into it. These are all the stock options that you get by clicking that button, but you can configure to your heart's content. After initializing our repository on GitHub, we'll go through the building, cloning, installing dependencies, and application build steps. And once our app is built and deployed, we can check it out at the subdomain that's set up for us. We're getting an internal server error, which we'll take care of momentarily. Right now, I want to continue to project. Here, I'll see all my stats and settings, and I can go to that GitHub repo if I want to clone it, run it locally, or see the additional instructions. In the README, we'll find that we need to add a WorkOS client ID and a WorkOS client secret conveniently found in our WorkOS dashboard. I'll jump over there and copy both of those now. Back in our Cloudflare worker, go to Settings, Variables, and Secrets, and add our two keys. The WorkOS client ID is not technically a secret, so we can store that in plain text. We don't want to deploy just yet until we get that other key in, so we'll save a version, then add our client secret. We'd like to encrypt using WorkOS client secret as the variable name and our WorkOS API key as the value. This time we can deploy. Now that we have all the values set up, go to deployments to make sure that it went out, and we can refresh. We get a 404 not found, which is a new error because the route that we have set up for our MCP interface is SSE. We get an invalid token error, which is actually a good thing. It means that everything is set up correctly so far. Back in the project README, we'll find a way to test our MCP authentication using the Cloudflare Workers AI Playground. Navigate there. Here in the Workers AI LLM Playground, we can add an MCP server using our subdomain from Cloudflare. Once added, just hit connect. We're immediately redirected to WorkOS AuthKit, where we get an invalid redirect URI error. And that's because we haven't added it to WorkOS. So back in the WorkOS dashboard, navigate to redirects, and in sign in callback, click edit redirect URIs. At our Cloudflare subdomain with route callback and add. Back in the Cloudflare playground, now try connecting again. Here we can log in with our user and password and be authenticated into our MCP server. Out of the box, this MCP server has one available tool, which is to add two numbers the way only MCP can. So let's try it with a request. What is 42? The answer to the universe, life, and everything plus 42. We see that the tool add was used to get the value 84, and the assistant responded with the answer 242 plus 42 is 84. Now, validating our tools inside of a playground is helpful, but not altogether useful. So let's take this one step further and integrate this MCP server into our cursor editor. Here in cursor, we can open up our cursor settings and navigate to MCP. Here we have the option to add new global MCP servers. This is currently done in a JSON file where we'll name the server, give it a command to run, and arguments. As soon as I hit save, I'll be asked to authenticate using WorkOS AuthKit, and we're good to use this from cursor. Cloudflare has a helpful doc in their AI repository under demos, remote MCP GitHub OAuth that includes some getting started, troubleshooting, and argument setup type stuff. So this has been a quick demonstration of how to get an MCP server set up using Cloudflare and WorkOS for authentication. If you subscribe to the channel, then next week you'll see our video on adding authorization to allow certain tools to be used with certain permissions. You won't want to miss it, so get subscribed. I'm Chantastic. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.